Ladies and gentlemen, heroes of all ages, welcome back to the Heart of the Storm. This is episode number 33 of HotsCast, recorded 9 p.m. on the right coast, 30th December 2014. HotsCast is the podcast for the people, the players, the heroes, covering all the awesome that is the Blizzard Entertainment Brawler, Heroes of the Storm. I'm your host, Vincent Minucci, a.k.a. Rillandoon, with me as always, except for last week and the week before, are my intrepid co-hosts. First up, we have Kaylee, who was not here the week before, a.k.a. Nerdy Char, a.k.a. get the heck out of your garrison and get back in the Nexus.
Yeah, that's exactly where I've been. You don't yell too well. Yeah, sorry I missed last show, guys. My love for Tolkien definitely outweighs my love for all other geekery. So when it was Hobbit premiere night, I had to be there.
It's all good. I saw The Hobbit yesterday, and it was awesome.
It was so good. And I'm sorry, but all of the freaking headbutting was just, like, the best.
The headbutting was great.
I was dying.
Put Billy Connolly in every movie ever made, ever. Yeah. Just yeah. Billy Connolly. All the Billy Connolly lead.
So, for this week's video game quote, I decided to go super mega old school. The quote is, "You have died of dysentery." If you don't know where that's from, then your childhood is very sad to me.
Yes, very sad indeed. Yes, yes indeed. Sorry, there is a sound like running water behind me. You guys hear that?
I think so.
No. I hear nothing.
Bloody heck is that sound? Is that somebody shooting my house with a hose or something?
Maybe somebody is. Is it Santa?
I'm sorry.
It must be like as if it was raining, but it's not raining.
It's me distracting you so I can take your Hobbit beer.
Might be dreaming. I don't know.
You're dreaming? Maybe it's Santa. Sound.
Maybe. next up, we have Mike, a.k.a. Finless, a.k.a. you too need to get the heck out of your garrison.
Yeah, I do. Out of all 4, 5, 7, 8 of my garrisons. My quick and witty hello something is a quote. It's not a gaming quote. We can't take any credit for our talents. It's how we use them that counts. And that is from A Wrinkle in Time.
That is a lovely quote. I like this quote.
That is a good quote.
It's very end of the year, making your resolutions. It's very good.
Right. Exactly. I like that. Very nice.
Yes. We also can't take credit for the fact that we're really bad at anything. It's how we don't use it that counts, I guess, or something. I don't know.
Don't use the counts. Wow, use that just...
things were bad. I don't know.
Dude, that's like something a philosophy bomb that just hit me in the face, and I'm just like...
Yes. that was actually the noise out the window was the philosophy bomb.
I'm still wondering what that noise is. It almost sounds like a huge storm, like water driving.
It's actually in your head. It's in your head. And what's really weird is we can hear it too. That's the problem.
I can hear it.
I am calling the show title Mysterious Water Philosophy Bomb. I think that should
there you
be.
Go.
Oh. Never mind.
Did you figure out what it was?
Do tell, sir.
Is it like leaking in your... Do you have a water bottle or something?
It's something silly.
I've been really bad with cleaning my desk lately. So I have this giant pile of crap sitting on the floor next to my desk.
Slowly falling over? Is that the noise?
No, it just happens to be covering the air vent and the heat.
Oh, because it's blowing.
So it's blowing against the bottom of a couple comic books,
paper,
two magazines, and a bag of something I need to return.
That's just means you're a real gamer. I'm very proud of you, Real.
Oh my, there's a pile of, like right here, there's a pile of stuff that includes, hold on, the official quotable Doctor Who book, nice. Original Sin number 19, Guardians of the Galaxy. What else? Hold on. Star Wars t-shirt. Got that right there. I mean, you should see the pile. Just crap. What else? This is cool. This is really cool. You know, we should talk a little bit about what we got for Christmas and whatnot if we want to real quick. This is cool. This is probably one of the coolest things I got for Christmas. Now, I should say I actually picked it out for myself. I put it on my Twitter wish list. That's not
from
what that's
Amazon?
Called. Amazon, thank you. Twitter wishlist. What the hell's wrong with me?
Hey, Twitter, you gotta
have a wishlist. It is called Maker Dad. And it is lunchbox guitars, anti-gravity jars, and 22 other incredibly cool father-daughter DIY projects. And it's by Mark Fraunfelder. I heard an interview with this guy. I should remember how to pronounce his last name. Fraunfelder. He's editor-in-chief of Make Magazine. And it's all these like cool kind of geeky DIY projects you can do with your daughter. I thought that was awesome. So I'm looking for...
I don't have a daughter, so I can't.
You don't have a daughter. You have two sons. And two sons do not make a daughter.
Tale of two sons.
I also got... Neither do two wrongs. This is something I've wanted for a while, too. Banksy, Wall and Peace. I love Banksy. Banksy is an awesome graffiti artist.
From, I got this. And this.
England. UK.
This is the two things I got.
You got that. You got that. You got
my Moto 360 and my Fire.
Shoot, I have severely messed up the balance of my pile of crap, so it might come like a landslide. It may fall
down at any point. This is a good mirror.
That is a good mirror. It's very shiny. Very shiny. Hey, look. Oh, I see myself.
It's like
Inception.
It's like
Inception tablet.
Not... Speaking of Inception, no, we won't talk about Dr. Who. Oh, yes. Awesome.
For the audio viewers, I'm holding up to the camera an AOL or an America Online 5.0 with 250 free hours for a month. Whoa. DVD shrink
wrap. That's a pretty old one. I think AOL is on 8 now or something.
Yeah.
Did you need a new coaster for your desk?
Dude, I'm hanging this on the wall. Are you kidding me? This is great. I got this from my brother-in-law. I was setting up his new computer, and he had that in his old computer's drawers. And I was like, dude, I'm keeping this.
There was a guy who used to collect those, and he would mail them to people.
Computer had pants?
What? Did I pee my
Sorry,
pants?
Nothing. No, his old computer had pants. You said it was in his drawers.
A bad game of telephone. Like, it just...
Yes.
Your whisper down the lane thing. Ooh, desk is creaking.
We still have not talked anything about Heroes, but that's okay.
No, we will in a second.
No, like if people would send him junk mail, he would take the reply envelopes and stuff them full of AOL discs and mail them back.
That'd be awesome. I love that. I love that. He's my hero. So apparently, I'm the only one that's been playing Heroes in the last week.
I played a little bit of Heroes.
How much is a little bit?
A little bit. I don't know, like two or three games. Since we had a show, probably like five games.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. All right, what else have you been playing, Kaylee?
Me? Oh, Kaylee's got to go first.
Kaylee.
That's true.
I did play a few games of Hearthstone because
Did you get Goblins versus Gnome stuff?
Yes.
I did. Just to get the car backs.
Oh.
Logged in.
Well, I was somewhere where the only thing I had was a tablet, so it was like either Hearthstone or nothing. It's not that I don't like Hearthstone; it's just like I'm not super good at the deck making strategy. I'm trying to get Joel to help me with that because he's like wicked good at it.
Nice.
He's like, what rank are you? Aren't you like really high rank?
Very nice. Play Hearthstone.
I don't know. He's 10. I bring 10. So,
I just haven't played enough to get a legend.
I don't know. He's getting up there, but
it'll go right back to 25 in a couple days.
25, right?
Angry Chicken. Angry Chicken.
Is 25. Yeah. So I'm ranked 26.
Yeah.
Because I sucked that bad that they actually created a 25. Special the real rank.
I'm right there with you. I am awful.
Rank 26.
I'm trying to build new decks based on my 20 something. New card packs of Goblins versus Gnomes that I picked up when it came out.
Right.
I picked up 20 and I got a free one of some sort and whatever. So I opened all those up. I got two legendaries in them.
Two. Count them. One, two. A
couple epics.
Did you really?
I didn't get
any. Yeah. I got a couple rares.
And I don't know. My problem is like I go online to try to build a deck like, oh hey, do this, and I don't have half the cards.
Right.
So it's like, well, I know. How am I supposed to do that?
I know. I do the same thing. Anytime I look up like a card building strategy, it's like, I don't have that. Don't have that. Don't have
especially
that.
Especially if they include legendaries. But there's a few that you can get that don't have legendaries. I still win, though. Like, I'll play and I'll win with my hunter deck, and just depends.
Right.
And how crappy the person I play. Like, if I play real, you know, maybe.
I did win one game, but I think the reason I won was because the person fell asleep because they their timer ran out.
Timed out.
So I was like, woo! I'm watching the thing go across. I'm like, don't move. Just let it go out. Anyway,
It was probably a kid who was like, Joe, go take the garbage out. Like, no, it's my turn, Mom. Too bad. Go take the garbage out. Okay.
That's the beauty of the iPad, is you can take it with you.
Yeah, take it with you. I'm carrying my fire with me. And like, okay, I'm taking the garbage out.
You see, like, the card swaying back and forth.
Yeah. Yeah. What's going on?
You pirate blast yourself in the face.
Yes. Exactly.
Nice. Yes. So what have you been playing, Mike? Actually, you've been playing a lot.
Played World of Warcraft a lot, like way too much. I wasn't off last week, the first 3 days, but I've been off since Wednesday, since Thursday of last week. So I've had a lot of time to play a lot of things. So I'm playing World of Warcraft a lot. I played Dragon Age Inquisition a lot today, actually. Really love that game a lot. So I've been wanting to put more time into it, and finally I've been able to. Divinity Original Sin, really like that game. That's a really great throwback game in some respects, even though it's new. Don't throw it back. It's actually on sale on Steam right now, so if you're interested in it, really good game. Pick it up if you like that kind of thing. Skylanders Trap Team on my new Fire HDX. It's fun. I mean, yeah, it's kind of a kiddie game, but it's fun. I like platformers, and Skylanders is a pretty good platformer. So, okay. Hearthstone, which we talked about a bit, and I did play a few games of Heroes since our last show, maybe like four or five. Lost a lot, won a couple. We raffle stomped some team. Oh my god, we just like one good thing about queuing solo. Is you tend to end up on some better teams than when you queued two or three, I guess.
Yeah.
I ended up on some pretty good teams when I queued solo and was like, we just destroyed the other team. And that was
queuing two is rough. Queuing with three, I think you're in a little bit better position. Four, you're good.
Depends on how good you guys are as
actually,
a team.
Three, though, I think, course. Is the golden kind of number. Like, if you queue four or five, then you're going up against another pre-made most of the time.
Yes.
So three, you got to be really on your ball.
Twos or threes.
But queuing up as two, I think it almost puts you into a group with three other randoms, but then you go up against a five-man pre-made because you're technically queuing as a group, it seems. Because, yeah, I've gotten raffle stomped hard lately. With Muzzle, my buddy Muzzle Ben, he and I queuing up together, and I will say what I've been playing. I did play some WoW. I have been playing Draenor. Garrisons are awesome. The zones are.
You got 100 yet, or are you just still screwing around?
No, I'm 94. 94 on my rogue. actually in the.
It really does not take long to level, man. What are you doing? Well, you're obviously not leveling. Well, you're obviously not doing anything other than garrison stuff.
I don't have to level.
You like don't even have to try to level.
I'm just walking around reading all the quest text and I'm not really taking my time. No, I'm playing too much Heroes. Now Ro says there's no such thing as too much WoW, but when you're trying to level in WoW, there is a such thing as too much Heroes, and I'm playing a lot of Heroes. Yes.
I haven't noticed you in Heroes though. I mean, I've been on
WoW
a lot.
Really, like, no, you I've every time I log in I see you and your garrison.
Well, so that may not be anything, and logging out and logging in different people. So you should message me and go, "Hey, let's play Heroes." See, if you did that, I would come and play. See, if you see, it's your fault. I blame you.
You
don't
blame
bother
me.
You have my garrison. If I'm sitting on my garrison, yo, hey, I wouldn't want to bother you in your garrison, but why don't you come? Like, I'm picking flowers. Right. Bother me,
dude. I just figured out that all these dots under my garrison, I'm like, what are all these dots? They're driving me nuts.
Mine, you freak.
It's the mine.
Yeah. Wait until you unlock the farm, and then you can. Yeah.
But Farmville or anything like that. So I don't have that whole background. Yes. But I have been playing a lot of Heroes. I have gotten pretty much everybody to level 5. I have three or four heroes that are not level 5 right now that I need to cap out. I'm sitting on 22,000 gold. Wow. I'm reserving 10 of that for Tyrael's Master Skin. Getting from 8 to 9 is ridiculous. There's
just
so
wait to get from 9 to 10.
Oh my gosh, I don't even want to know. 2.5 million XP takes so long. And I'm
Do it now because you get a bonus.
I'm doing it with I'm only playing Tyrael when I'm with friends because I need that XP. Right. I need the friend bonus, the holiday bonus.
Well, you can play Tyrael after this if you want.
I'll be playing Tyrael.
Yeah, Rill, you and I should get together because I want to do the 40 to get the extra portrait. So you and I should just marathon it.
Let's do it. Because I'm 34 and a half right now, and I can't remember if I got 40 before. Before I go any further, my buddy Zach wants me to give him a shout out. He's in the chat room. What's up, buddy? How you doing?
Hi, buddy Zach.
He called you Wince. What's that?
He called you Wince.
All right. It's all good. I changed his diapers. It's all right.
Oh dear.
I refer to him and his brothers and his sister as my niece and nephews, even though they're not. We have been very, very close as a family for, how old is Zach now? 15 years, 16 years? My wife actually worked for them when she was in college. So I've known this kid since he was 3 years old. So, yeah, he's awesome, the whole family. But we saw The Hobbit yesterday together. All right, let's get on to some actual Heroes news.
Let's actually do the show.
Let's actually do the show. we had a very brief year in review article from Vayflair. Vayflair, right? I think Vayflair posted it. Hold on, let me click over. Yes, Vayflair posted it. You can check out the link. It'll be in the show notes. And there is some good information in there. They talk about how it's been a jam-packed week, year, 2014. It really has.
Really long year.
Really long week.
It's like a 365-day week.
Yeah.
Nine months.
It's just 9 months, that's right. Even though we've been broadcasting for a little over a year, the game's only been out for 9 months because we just pontificated upon something that didn't exist for the first
time. We talked about League for 3 months.
Is it time for BlizzCon again yet?
I know.
Financially, I'm not, but every other part of me is.
Right. Yes. Mentally, I'm there.
See, remember, right after BlizzCon, he was like, I don't think I'm going to BlizzCon next year. Now he's like, when's BlizzCon? I want to go to BlizzCon.
I said, I don't think I can afford to go to BlizzCon.
Afford it. That's true.
I definitely
he's like, go to BlizzCon. I don't care.
That's semantics, Thrill. Okay?
Just start walking.
Did I afford to go to BlizzCon this past year? Probably not.
You drive a lot, right? So you could drive.
Drive a lot? Well, speaking
that
of
that is a long drive.
My 2014 vehicle that, well, it's, I don't own it. It's my company vehicle. I hit 53,000 miles this morning.
Oh,
it's a 2014.
That's so many miles.
Nice. That's a lot of miles. Yes. And there's a lot of stats in this article. Over the last 9 months, they've introduced 32 powerful and unique heroes, 5 dynamic battlegrounds, and so ready for those next two. Bring them on.
Yes.
Oh, they're ready. So good. Well, at least the one that we got to play. 111 skins. That's a lot of skins. 12 steadfast mounts. And I like this part, with more on the way. Now, is that more all of them on the way or more mounts? What do you think?
All.
There's a comma there. So grammatically.
It was all mounts probably. But it should be all
just mounts. Okay, so we're going to stay at 32 heroes, 111 skins, 5 battlegrounds. We're going to get
more on the way for all of them. Yes, 50 mounts. It's just going to be mounts. Mounts and mounts and mounts.
Yes. Tal'thar lives. He lives.
Yes, he does. I like the fact that there are 369 different color tints available across all the heroes' skins and mounts.
Yes, that's a lot. And if you guys actually, if you harken back to the infamous Samwise interview, he talked about they're very specific with the coloring, with the tints. Like, you'd almost think not that it would be like a throwaway decision what colors, but they kind of like, I mean, they have meetings about the color, you know, the tints, yep, and the variations. And, you know, they took risks with some. And even, you know, he and I were talking about one of the color variants on Tyrael that I just absolutely love. And he's like, you know, it's crazy that everybody loves it, because at first I saw it and I was like, yeah, I wasn't sure, but now everybody loves it. So it's kind of cool to see that the color, yep, variations mean that much, that there's that much effort and time put into them. And it's cool. I mean, some of them, you know, it's not like just a straight red filter or green filter. You know, Nova,
no, they
for
really
instance.
They don't, they never do that. That's always right. Just a coloration. It's, they redo different. The whole thing with different colors.
Right. I mean, Nova's hair is a different color. Her, I think even her eyes are a different color, right? I know Uther's, yep, eyes get a different color. His beard and his hair is a different color. I mean, they really go in depth with it, and they almost go thematic too. You know, yep, like Uther, he goes from like his traditional golden paladin to almost like Death Knight Uther, like black, and his tome, his spell book is red, and then his third is kind of like this aged warrior of wisdom, like his golden armor is more bronze and he's got gray hair, and there's a thematic element to it. And I love that third color variation on Uther. That is by far, yep, my favorite. Like, I actually preferred that even when I don't own the Battle Medic anymore. I bought it in before the last wipe. I preferred, mm-hmm, that third color variant to the Battle Medic skin. The Battle Medic skin was, yeah, awesome, but that third color variant of the just standard Uther, I just loved it so much. Yep. So it's cool, yep, to see, you know, how much they're
put a lot of time into it. Into, yeah, 369 different ones.
369, yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot. Yeah. Well, the another thing they have in this article, which is cool, is stuff that they're talking about for what's coming next too. So it's just not like, let's talk about what happened, but also what is coming and what their plans are, or some of them anyway.
Well, right, they're kind of vague, but
yeah, of course. They're always vague. It's Blizzard. Yeah. It's Blizzard vagueishness. Yeah,
I mean, you kind of have to be. You don't want to promise too much. Tal30 mentioned actually something pretty cool in the chat. He said if the abilities change tints as well, they would have the best skins of any game. That would be, yeah, really freaking cool.
Well, they do. They are looking supposedly at least for the skins changing some of the
yes,
graphics for the abilities and stuff. And you can also see that on Infested Tychus.
Yes,
has the, right, Infested laser too. So that's a, right, little something, not completely. But if they went that way, that would be very cool if they could,
like,
add
cool
some additional
see,
functionality like that.
Like Nova's triple tap. Change from, yeah, that like blue, crystal blue, to like a red or a green,
yeah,
you know, based on color variant.
Yeah, I don't think, yeah, it would be a huge deal probably to change those colors based on the tint you pick.
Right. I mean, it's kind of like the same along the same lines with WoW, with you know, with Warlocks changing their,
yep,
their
purple.
What do they call it?
Their fire.
Spew fire.
Green, fire, purple fire.
Demon fire. I've never played a Warlock. No.
Green fire, purple fire, doesn't matter.
Evil fire of evilness.
Fire of fireness. Fire of colorness.
Well,
anything stand out to you, Kaylee?
Yeah, obviously one of the most controversial topics, so I've of course got to bring it up.
Of course, you're Miss Controversy. Come on.
I am devil's advocate all the way. They talked about updated social systems on the horizon. So, of course, me being the troll / crap talker in game, I'm hoping for all chat. See, I know a lot of people are hoping for not all chat.
Typical.
Well, I'm hoping for like guilds and or communities and stuff like they did in Diablo. That's what,
right,
I'm looking for.
Kaylee just
I
wants
to see
smack
that.
Talk. We want to have more fun, but Kaylee just wants, yes, to like smack talk.
This is a competitive style game. I want the competitive feel. It feels too friendly right now. And I know that's Blizzard's thing, but
I don't know. I'm not friendly against the other team, but I don't need to smack talk them. I can tell my teammates that, look at how much we're killing them.
I don't really care if they care. If the Y ping had a little bit more,
yeah,
to it.
That needs,
like,
to happen.
There's six. What is there? Six things on the wheel. I literally have only ever hit well played, like goodbye. No reason for that. Well, I mean, I guess that's like you can kill somebody.
Kill
hit goodbye.
Somebody.
That's not enough though. Like,
they should have like evil laugh. Mwah.
Yeah. Put taunts
Fellfire
in there.
Rose, like, says, by the way.
Well, even
the color.
Learn to warlock. Yeah, sorry, Ro. I do need to learn to warlock.
Even if all chat was just for competitive modes, you know, like ranked games,
mm-hmm.
that would make me happy. Yeah, I mean, there's a whole component. There's a whole different part of MOBAs where it's called putting someone on tilt, where right. you trash talk them. Right. And you put them off their game. I mean, I love that part of the game.
You know, that would be good. That would be good if that's in ranked play. I like that. I like that idea for that to be exclusive to ranked play. And we've talked about this. We've talked about Blizzard has the ability here to separate out very specific things for ranked play and for, I'm not even going to use the
non-ranked.
C word, but
non-ranked.
Normal play. Yeah,
ranked and non-ranked. How's that?
Non-ranked play. You
know, and all others.
And all others, right. And, you know, I've heard, I mean, the guys in the Nexus, Stacks and Packs especially, like he hates cooperative mode. He hates co-op mode. Like he hates the fact that people can complete the quests in co-op mode because this is a PvP game. And if you're not going to play PvP, go back to playing WoW. Which is kind of funny for me because I play on a very ridiculously PvP-centric server to the point where there were like 7 Horde 100s camping a level 93 quest area, and it's pissing me off to no end. And
no wonder you're not leveling quickly. You're on PvP. Yeah, well, yeah, never mind. Now I understand.
Yeah. Had a really good fight, though, that lasted like 27 minutes. It was like a pretty epic fight. Salt fun. What? Look, there are two types of games, salt, S-A-L-T, ranked, and fun, unranked. I don't get
the
salt.
He's saying the people are
salty. Salt is caps.
Oh, salty.
Or
okay.
Salt is maybe? Caps, so I don't know. Maybe that's it's an acronym.
Is that an acronym? Is it an initialism?
Acronism?
Acronym?
You said anachronism. It's not an acronym. I promise you, it's not an acronym. It could be an acronym.
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 Acronym. Nim, like no. Secret of Nim, like the, you know, with the mice.
Acronism sounds like something that
acronym.
Happens in your brain that kills you.
Hold on.
An anachronism is something that's an old, like, way of doing something.
Oh, shoot, you're right. There is no word anachronism. Acronym. What?
Yeah. You just held down shift for some reason.
Talfa's saying, like, salty people, like, angry.
Angry people, okay. But not that Rank's going to be angry.
People
but
who really care and people who don't. No, not really.
Competitive.
That's not it.
Competitive and non-competitive. And
what do you
I think
even need names for? Ranked and non-ranked.
Opportunity to tailor fit those two things, competitive and non-competitive play. And I think that'd be a great way to do it. For instance, competitive play, you should be able to see what map you're getting before you choose your hero. You don't necessarily need that non-competitive play. You're just throwing another variable into the mix that doesn't need to be there for the non-competitive players. For the competitive players, you want to see what map you're gonna get before you choose your hero, because, for instance, Hammer. I played I actually started getting pretty good as Sergeant Hammer. I'm really loving her changes, but she's kind of painful to play on Cursed Hollow because that is a big friggin' map, and if you're in the bot lane and the Trib pops in the top. It takes a long time.
No, if you're Sergeant Hammer and you're playing in Cursed Hollow, you are not going after Tribs. You have 4-man Tribs at that point. You basically stay in your lane.
You wish.
You push your lane when everybody else goes. If everybody else is going, you're supposed to stay in your lane.
Yes,
yeah, so
that'd be
Hammer.
Nice. Except when you
people
have
who don't go.
Uther that's just kind of spinning around the turret in your base,
yeah,
like
well.
Just. Doing laps around it.
Well, then you're gonna lose. So you might as well just stay in your lane and have fun. Yeah, don't worry about it.
And you've got an Illidan who thinks that like level 3 he can solo a bruiser camp by himself.
Yes, sure.
Yeah, that was a painful match to say the least. But yes, yeah, separating
stay in lane and lose
be good. So give Kaylee her smack talk. Her smack
sure.
talk ability, but do it in rank.
See, I don't have any problem with it because like in League, I would just ignore it. So I just ignored the all chat.
You can
he would
turn
be like,
chat off.
Why are you going blah, blah, blah? Why did you buy that blah, blah, blah? I'm like, I'm not even going to reply because
dude,
I'm
you
not.
You should
I'm,
see my
care.
List
it's great.
Unblocked players.
Yeah, I
like,
just ignore.
I have comblocked so many people. It's like, I don't even want to deal with these people anymore. Super angry, loud talk. Oh, Saul.
Nah,
super angry,
okay,
loud
sure.
Talk.
That's it.
Okay. All chat, yes.
That's the PC version.
Yes.
The PG like, version.
I'm definitely looking forward to ranking. I'm looking forward to quitters getting put in with other quitters.
Are you saying like you rank?
What's that? Yeah, quitter is a rank.
Are you saying your rank? No, your rank. No. You can't to ranking. Is that is that actually like a thing? Ranking? I didn't know that was a word?
You're a baseball fan and you don't know the word ranking or ranking system?
Like what? Yeah, but a ranking system is different than that. You can't wait to be ranking or something. The way you used it was bad.
So I forgot to say system afterwards. Send me
oranges. I'm just confused. No, they're ugly. I'm not sending you any oranges.
Sorry, you have no idea what that means. Unless
you know what? I'm going to send you some tangerines. And if you know what I mean, then you've watched something recently that's from that kind of like Inception.
So yeah, that's pretty much everything we can glean.
I like tangerines.
I like tangerines.
Those are good. Those aren't tangerines.
No, they're not. Basically, they ended this article with saying January 13th is the closed beta. It is coming.
I assume they're leaving the matchmaking points, the behind the scenes matchmaking levels and everything for this, because if not, those new people are going to be playing a lot of very good people right away.
Yeah, that's something I'd like to see a little bit worked out a little bit more. I mean, at the moment, I guess there's not enough players to do this, but it's very clear when you've got level 2 people going up against level 35 people.
Yeah.
And it'd be nice to suss that out a little bit. You know, I'm not saying
unless those level 35 people got to level 35 by losing every game they've played.
Yes.
In which case, playing level 2 is fine.
That's where ELO comes into play.
Yeah.
But they did just release another, I think it must have been the final round of Alpha Invites.
ELO?
Yeah, ELO.
Electric Light Orchestra?
No.
Yes. Electric Light Orchestra, exactly.
It's the matchmaking scoring system behind the scenes. Yeah.
Oh. I don't know. Heard that
effective level something, I think, or something like that.
Yeah. Effective.
I've heard that actually.
Hold on. I'll Google it. But anyways, while I'm doing that, one of my like real life friends just got an alpha invite. So they must have just done one last like hurrah round of invites before the beta.
Yes.
Okay. Make sure
there was a bunch of people that I know that just got an invite.
Yes. Make sure your beta profile settings in your Battle.net account, make sure you have heroes checked. You know, it's very
and while important. You're there, set Overwatch too.
And also check Overwatch. Yes.
The
Overwatch.com.
The ELO rating system is a method for calculating relative skill levels of players in competitive versus competitor games, named after its creator, Arpad Elo, Hungarian American physics professor. So it's
it doesn't
not
actually
an acronym,
stand for
it's
anything.
Actually, yeah.
Guys, it's his name. So he wrote an algorithm, basically.
We need the little star, the more you know.
I have the audio somewhere, I think, in my...
And if you're under the age of 20, you have no idea what that means.
It's true. The I'm more surprised you didn't just make a joke about me.
I was about to, and you cut me off.
I got carded today. For champagne, I was so thrilled.
Dude, I got carded.
I did
at
not
Wegmans.
Get carded.
I went to buy the Hobbit beer. Like the first guy, actually, I bought it 2 different times. And the guy, I look at him like, "Do you really need to see my ID?" And he looks up at me. He goes, "No." I bought the beer.
And
let's check out at Publix, and they completely ignored me.
Well, I go back up again, and the girl says, "Can I see your ID?" I go, "Really? That guy didn't card me." I'm like, "Look at the gray in my beard. Do I really look like I'm under 21?" Well, really.
In Florida, if you look under 40, they card you.
I don't look under 40. I'm only 34, but I don't look under 40. I'm bald and I have a gray beard.
I am over 40, so I guess they decided not to look at me. I don't know. That's. I am. Yeah, I am.
What? I thought you were 38 or.
That's like.
I was like. 4 years ago.
It's your 40th birthday.
I don't know. It was a year ago, August.
What? How is this possible?
Last August. I don't know. Years go by.
And still,
because generally we don't like announce all these things online.
Never mind. Days go by. Never mind. Yes, I got to stop singing during episodes. Talthar wants Ninja Uther, by the way.
I agree.
Ninja Uther.
That's okay. I was 22, and actually, I was 19, and people weren't carding me. But
I never got carded for anything.
I looked old when I was very young. So
I had this level of beard, just minus the gray, when I was 15.
Well, I look younger now because I have no hair. When I had hair, I had so little that I looked really old.
Good point.
So,
good point.
I look younger the longer my hair is.
Well, there you go. Me too.
No, like the pigtails.
No, not me.
I don't know why I just did that.
Anyway, so so January 13th is the closed beta. It's coming up two weeks, and there will be a huge influx. Now, one thing to worry about: you worry about the server stability?
Yes,
at all.
Yes, because
do you think they're going to get DDoSed on the 13th?
If they get DDoSed, I swear to God, you freaking lizard people. Oh, my God.
Anonymous has declared war on them. Anonymous has declared war on them. Did you see that? Anonymous declared war on them. Yes, Anonymous is going after them.
Lizards?
Yeah, because Anonymous is all gamers, so they're going after Lizard Squad or whatever the heck they
are. Oh, Anonymous is going after Lizard Squad.
I've renamed them Lizard Boop.
Good. is there a Patreon for Anonymous? Because I would like to fund...
You would like to anonymously fund Anonymous? Like anonymous? Is that what you
$1 a month to Anonymous.
But no, well,
you should tell them. Anonymous, you should set up a Patreon. Send us coffee if we give you a certain amount.
Wait, that doesn't... There's something about that.
Now, Blizzard said in the WoW movie that they played at BlizzCon that they've learned from their mistakes and that... You know, they're better prepared for launches, so hopefully...
It didn't happen after that.
...server issue. Joel's giving me a look like, yeah, freaking right.
Draenor was pretty good.
No, it was not. Yeah, it was horrible. The original launch of Warlords
No, Warlords was... the first day or two was bad. That's true.
Well, the problem is the combination of whatever issues they had and the DDoS. Because really, more than anything, it was the DDoSing... Yeah, they were, that was the biggest problem. It wasn't that their servers couldn't take it. The DDoS was causing problems for, like, certain world servers and not others, so you were stuck in your garrison because the world server was down because of the DDoS attack, but the garrison server was fine. So it was just stupid things like that.
So, again, screw you, Lizard Squad, and your stupid lizards.
Poop.
Lizard tails. Poop.
We'll cross lizard our fingers.
Tails. Yes.
I don't know if they're going to, like... Just because they open close beta doesn't open close beta. I don't know. open close. They doesn't mean that we need a door sound. Doesn't mean that they are going to like all of a sudden invite 200,000 people on one day. You know, number one, we don't know how many people they're planning on inviting for close beta. Number two, I assume that they have some kind of tiered, like, this is how many we're going to invite, just like they did with Alpha. They're not going to like. Throw them all in at once. It's going to be like, here's the first phase, here's the second phase, and just slowly ramp them up. And then at some point, I have a feeling they're going to just dump a bunch of people in because I think they want to see how the servers react. Like, if we dump 50,000 people on it all at once, what's going to happen?
No, they're going to dump like 300,000.
Yeah, whatever they do. But I think they're going to do a few of those where they're going to see and they just dump everybody on at once. Now, that could be open beta also because you know that that's going to be like 3 million people all at one time. So,
you know what the worst part is? With every passing week that goes by, we get further and further away statistically from ever seeing chicken sandwich again.
That's true.
Yeah.
That is the worst part.
Although, depending upon the changes they make to the social systems, we may be able to find him.
Yeah, if you could search by, like, just search by name player name. You know what I've been noticing, actually? A lot of people play or have... a lot of Spanish speaking people. I've been getting a lot of Spanish speaking people in games lately. They use the real names, like first name, last name. But I've seen a lot of that, and it's not like Inigo Montoya. Like it's their actual names.
Darn, that's what I wanted to use.
Although that would be good. My name is Inigo Montoya. You killed my hero. Prepare to die. That would actually be pretty good.
Mike, you should use your mad like graphic designer skills to make us like a missing poster with chicken sandwich.
Missing chicken sandwich.
Help us find chicken
probably sandwich. Could do that. Yeah. Do you remember what he played though? That's the question. I don't remember what he played. No. I was thinking of just making it a boomkin or something because it's chicken sandwich. So that would be like the name of a boomkin, wouldn't it?
We can go back and see.
It has to be, right?
Oh, and
do you have the replay?
It would be in our replay.
I mean, if it's not a replay, we at least post it.
We did post what time it was. Yeah, it's true. We can probably find it.
I mean, it'd be, oh my gosh, that was like 6 months ago.
Yeah, I don't remember what he played. I don't remember what he played.
I don't know.
Well, I remember what he played.
It was a few weeks before we had that match with the guys from the Nexus, so we could kind of timestamp it off that.
Maybe, yeah.
Because that was
we know when sandwich. It was in a show, right? So we knew that in the show we talked about it. So
we talked about it, yeah.
Yeah, so we would have to go by that. True. I don't know. If anybody remembers.
Find our chicken sandwich, please.
Somebody find our chicken sandwich.
Yes, please. Find our chicken sandwich.
Yes. That should be the t-shirt contest.
What's that?
There we go.
If you find chicken sandwich, you get the signed t-shirt.
There is a XP boost going on right now. If you've been playing Heroes, you noticed it already. It's in a login screen, but there is a holiday XP bonus that's going until, the 1st, I think? They shut it off?
It is till the 1st, yes.
Till the 1st,
24th
yes.
to the 1st, so that is a couple more days.
Yes, it's nice. The XP boost is nice. Also,
25%.
We alluded to earlier, 25%, thank you. There is, if you reached level 40 at any point in the technical alpha, you will be receiving a cool portrait reward, which is awesome. Portrait rewards are real big for StarCraft and Diablo, and I like that they're bringing them into Heroes. That's a pretty cool thing. So, very much like that. That
bonus also stacks additively with stim packs, by the way, if anybody's using stim packs.
Yes, if you're using the stim packs.
Additively. So if you get a 25% stim pack or whatever they are, then it would be 50%.
Right. Yes.
Because that's additively.
It's additive. It's too late to be doing additive, man. Come on. Too late. With that, I mean, do you guys... It's been a great year, I think. We've seen a lot of ups, a lot of downs. One down. We all know what my down was. I don't think I need to reiterate what my down was. We all know.
We don't need more nasty...
We don't need
iTunes feedback. Come on, roll.
Exactly. Yeah, that was funny. That was so funny that was the thing that prompted somebody to leave us an iTunes review was me ranting that they pulled out of the game. That is funny. We do need more. Do we have any iTunes? Did anybody look?
I don't know. I'll look right now.
Loaded on my computer, and the thought of putting iTunes on my computer gives me a rash. I really don't want to do it. So,
by the way, if you have Podcast Addict, you can find us on Podcast Addict. That's a pretty good Android podcast app.
It's a very good Android podcast app. I was using Stitcher on my work Android phone. Yep. I don't know what was, this is so weird. I actually kept I kept meaning to tell Stitcher about this. If I had, I had playlists. I had Heroes of the Storm playlists. I had gaming playlists, tech, all these playlists. What it would do is, it was arbitrary. It was random. It would stop either 3 minutes short of the ending, 11 minutes short, 12 minutes short, and it would jump to the next podcast in the playlist. So I missed the last 10 minutes of the show. So, and it would annoy the heck out of me. Then I had to pick up my phone. I had to go back to the show, and it wouldn't even remember the place where it had jumped. So I'd have to scroll through and try to find where I had listened to be able to hear the end of the show.
That is awesome.
So bloody annoying. I had to uninstall Stitcher. That's annoying. I was like, forget it. I can't handle it anymore. You're driving me nuts. So right. I don't know what the deal was with that. So I switched to Podcast Addict, and that is a very good app.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's a very good app. It has a lot of functionality. We have one from August 27th that I don't remember reading. And it's from Ace 0584.
Okay.
And it said, as someone who, and he gave us 5 stars, awesome podcast with even more awesome hosts.
Aww.
Thank you. We love you.
Whoever you are.
Sorry.
As someone who does his own Heroes podcast, this is the only other podcast that I make sure to listen to each week. Great hosts who have an awesome view of the game, even though it is just in the alpha.
That's
it actually
awesome.
It says
you.
Game Event Huff. But it's even though, I'm sure.
Oh, okay. Did he say he has a show?
It says, as someone who does his own Heroes podcast. Yes, Ace. I don't know.
Dude,
do we know Ace? Yeah, I don't know.
Send us an
email. Let us know. Ace0584.
Like 0584?
Yeah, 0584. So he has reviews of The Sundering, this Magic Trading Card, Game Database, and Monster Pet Shop. He didn't leave that many reviews. So
I want to plug his show. I want to know if this is the right guy. I'm going to assume 0584 means he was born May of 1984, but I could be wrong.
I don't know.
All right,
well,
he
there's a few different heroes.
If it is, the
there's same guy. Into the Nexus. There's Town Hall Heroes. There's Stormcast. There's the Nexus.
Oh, LOL Nexus. There's an Ace 0584 profile on LOL Nexus.
What's LOL Nexus?
I don't know.
Is that a show?
I don't know.
I don't either. LOL Nexus.
Yeah. Raptor profile.
League of Legend Nexus?
Oh. Ah. I think I saw the mystery.
Yes.
It's Adam.
Oh, it is Adam?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. Great. Thanks, Adam.
I found a MySpace profile for him.
Oh my God. Okay.
That's
awesome.
Funny.
Well, there you go. Now we know who it is. Now, see, he did say he left a review also, I think.
He did. You're right. And we didn't. You're right. Hey, you guys hear that rushing water sound again? AKA the air vent blowing against the comic books, magazine,
Wait,
and bags into return.
Can I just make a comment about how your house has heat on and mine has AC on?
Yeah, I have AC on too. It was hot out. It's hot out recently.
It is.
It's like crazy.
It's
hot.
Actually, it cooled down tonight.
It's freaking
hot.
Yeah, it did.
It was actually really hot. Uncomfortably hot. It was 55 degrees.
Oh my God. It's right now 64.
64 right now.
It is. Yeah. 22 degrees Fahrenheit right now.
It's 64 degrees tomorrow. And tomorrow the high is 74. And Saturday, the high is 82.
Oh,
twice as much as what you said was uncomfortably warm.
It was a high of 30.
Our low is 60.
45 on Sunday.
Our low is 60.
This is why we live in Florida.
next Thursday is a high of 25.
Nice. See, I like that. You guys all say, I miss it. I miss it.
I love it.
I miss it. But I don't live here for the weather.
Let's see. My in-laws have a house in the mountains about 2 hours from here. Let's see. It is... That's actually warmer there? No. Oh, that was their high. Never mind. Actually, it's not that much different. Yeah, it's about the same temperature. Never mind. But, yes, I like cold weather. Yeah, been a good year. Loving the changes they've been doing. And...
Can't wait for next year.
Nobody still has them. You can still see a MySpace profile on a Google search. I don't think MySpace even exists anymore, does it?
Yeah, they're trying to revamp their image, but
oh wait, didn't Justin Timberlake buy it or something like that?
I thought it was someone like that, but I don't think it was Justin Timberlake.
It's a weird purchase.
Pretty sure Justin Timberlake purchased it. Wow, look at that. It's actually not that bad looking of a site. It's all music, which makes sense. Oh, no, it's not. No. Whoa, wait a second. This is in the news section on MySpace.com. Aaron Paul to play Han Solo in Star Wars spinoff? Question mark.
What?
Oh, here you go. You were right. Justin Timberlake.
Han Solo call somebody a bitch.
In 2011, Justin Timberlake is taking a major role in the new direction of MySpace after he emerged as one of those behind the $35 million deal for the ailing social network.
Told you.
No, he didn't buy it himself.
Shot
but.
First, bitch. Do I need to edit that out? Should I edit that? I should probably edit that.
No, it's okay.
But it's, it's okay. Aaron Paul. It's Breaking Bad.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Do you guys have anything else to kind of cap off the year? 2014 craziness that has been Heroes?
I want to thank our listeners and yes. the awesome chat room that shows a couple people that show up for our late shows at night during the week. And I know it's a horrible time and really, yes, yeah. I really appreciate you guys showing up. I appreciate all the people who have been listening to us from the beginning and all the people we've gotten and also Green Lantern and all and everybody else. People we met at BlizzCon, everything. You guys have made it a really awesome year. It's been a lot of fun, and we can't wait for next year and to hopefully get even more people to listen to the show because they'll be playing the game and, you know, stuff. And I'm hoping next year we can start getting some guests on a little bit, some more people on and talk to maybe some of these rank people that you've been talking about. Oh wait, no, rank. These rank people. No, rank. These people, all these, some of these esports, people and streamers and maybe get some, devs on or community manager people or somebody.
Yeah, I've been poking some of the devs again, you know, saying, hey, we want to get you on the show.
Sleeping beast.
And sending some emails and some DMs and whatnot.
Well, we have, Spirian said he wanted to be on the show. He told me personally. He said, I want to be on the show.
Well,
they're a little busy trying to get this beta thing going, and it's the holidays and everything. So, yeah, I gave you. Can I give it to you?
Yeah, you did.
I'm like, I don't have it. So, so I'm looking forward to the next year. I'm looking forward to beta, welcoming all these new people in, and to more and better heroes and, and not better heroes like individual heroes, but the whole game. And finding more time to play, which would be good. And Rill's just got to poke me when he logs in and wants to play heroes, and I will log it. I will switch most of the time.
PowerPoint.
You know what? I have a very special thank you. Now, it's not heroes related, but it's related to Hotscast, but a very special thank you to the listeners for making me feel so welcome, because this was my first foray into podcasting, this show.
Yeah.
And everybody's been super supportive and nice, and I love you guys so much. And I thank you for that.
Yeah. I forget that a lot, because you came into it so natural. And, I mean, Mike and I have been, I mean, him longer than me, but we've been podcasting for years. So, you know, for us, it just was like old hat. But you, I mean, you hit the ball rolling, running.
Hit the ball rolling. Hit the ground running.
That's it. Okay.
You're an anachronism, Rill. You know that, right?
There's a reason why we started recording an hour early tonight. I am sick as a freaking dog, and I didn't want to skip another show.
You're always sick.
I have been sick my entire vacation.
I think you should make a New Year's resolution to not be sick next year at all.
Oh, that'd be wonderful. See, here's the one thing about living in the Northeast is everybody is sick. I mean, I don't know a single person right now that does not have the flu.
I was never sick in the Northeast. That was the best part.
Well, you lived in like Pittsburgh. That's different.
I didn't. I lived in Pittsburgh for 4 years. I lived in Boston for 7 years. People get sick in Boston.
I don't know anybody right now who isn't sick. My neighbor was in the hospital. Like, it's just everybody is sick. Everybody. I mean, you go into Wawa, which if you don't know what Wawa is, I feel sorry for you. Wawa is the greatest thing on earth. The cashier's like, everybody is.
Well, now I know why you guys are all sick, because everybody at Wawa is sick, and therefore you guys go to Wawa to eat, and now you get sick. So stop going to Wawa to eat. Stop eating your chicken sandwich at Wawa.
I get my Wawa chicken sandwich, and I get sick.
Now, one thing I did forget is that I would love to thank my fellow co-hosts here. Because you guys have made this year fun and enjoyable to be on the show, and I look forward to every week to record with you guys. And thanks to Rill. I don't know whether he actually invited me to join him in this show, or I like honed myself into it or something, or said,
I'm doing it with you. Too bad.
It was kind of a combination or something. I don't know. But I really enjoy casting with him. So it's been a pleasure. So,
this is definitely one of the best parts of my week, every week. Literally, like, my job has been, I mean, I've said this on the show, my job has been so stressful. Like, my stress level is through the roof. Like, I'm like on the verge of bursting, and this is.
Your stress level is through the ball.
Through the ball.
Hit the ground with the ball.
That sounds really different when you say it like that. And this show is real. If I didn't have this, like, I don't know what I'd do, honestly, because between you, I mean, I love talking to you guys. I love talking about heroes, and I love the listeners interacting with them. Just, I mean, the littlest things, like, just want to get a ping on Twitter, like, somebody enjoyed the show and, you know, follows and says, hey, you know, really enjoy the show, whatever, you know, and, or people that are just so thankful, like, when I follow them back, like, people get surprised when I follow them back, like, it's crazy, and like, oh, you know, thanks for following back, you know, literally love the show, I just wanted to follow you, and like, no, you guys, you're awesome, like, we love you, and yes, I would lose my sanity if it wasn't for this, so I appreciate it, and appreciate my co-hosts. I love you guys. It's been awesome. Talthar did put a pretty cool quote in there, and I actually never read the comic. I'm sure it's from that, but I'm going to read it because it's awesome, and it has to do with my Green Lantern ring sitting here. In brightest day and blackest night, no evil shall escape my sight. Let those who worship evil's might beware my power, Green Lantern's light. I do need to catch up on Green Lantern, and I just got a text from somebody who's in the chat room.
Nice.
Gonna put it in the
no, I think there. He's not in the chat room anymore. I think
he leave
for hot tub. It was hot tub time.
Hashtag hot tub time.
Yeah. You won't be able to see this, but yeah, he sent a picture of, yeah, he's in the hot tub. You guys have to come over and try this sometime. Zach, I love you, man.
Did they just get a hot tub for Christmas? Is that
no, they've had a hot tub for years. Oh, well. It's actually a really nice hot tub. It's outside, it's like in this like little like kind of sunk down, secluded.
That's the best little thing is when it's 10 degrees out in the hot, you're in the hot tub, and then you get out and you're like, oh, yep, my God.
I love when you're in the hot tub. And see, people in other parts of the world can't experience this, but you actually have snow falling upon your head, like collecting on your head, but you're in a hot tub that's like 98 degrees, and then you have snow on your head. Like, it's wild. It really is very interesting.
NSFW
hashtag hot tub.
It's Crayhen
right here in time to
Crayhen showed up for
10 o'clock for us to leave,
knowing it was the 9 o'clock show.
Well, if we're gonna stream, we should start.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's wrap this puppy up.
Okay.
Been a great year. Love you guys. Looking forward to more. And yeah, just gonna keep coming. We're gonna be having some again. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be having some guests on, some pro players, some devs. And yeah, 2015 is going to be a great year for heroes and for Hotscast. It'll just keep coming. Don't forget, you've got a whole other week to get in your submissions for the t-shirt contest. Just send us an email, hotscast@gmail.com. Let us know what your favorite skin is in the game. That's all it takes to enter into the contest. Been getting some more submissions for the small, but still more for the large. So, you know, either one could go either, you know, if you chances are getting close to par on them, but definitely send it in. Got a very interesting one. Again, I don't want to skew any results. I'm not going to say any what anybody's picking, but got a very interesting one the other day that we'll talk about when we give out the t-shirt, when we award the winners next week. That's coming next week, our first January show. Today, well, let's click on my little handy dang calendar. It'll be the 6th. So Tuesday, January 6th, the winner will be announced. So you have until then, Tuesday, January 6th to send it in, which means I have to post the show sometime before next Monday. I'll probably get it edited. Not tomorrow. Tomorrow's New Year's. The next day. I'll be sobering up and editing.
Sobering up.
Yes. I have 3 Hobbit beers to drink.
I'm going to
post a picture in the show notes. I'll post a picture of the 3 Hobbit beers.
I have 2 Strongbows, 1 Woodchuck, and 2 Red's Apple Ale.
Strongbow is amazing. Strongbow's an Irish
cider. And an Angry Orchard.
Okay.
Angry Orchard puts me to sleep.
The other night, Joel made me Malibu and Coke. I'd never had it before. Apparently, it's really
Malibu like rum?
Yeah.
Oh.
And I was like, that sounds really weird. And he's like, just drink it. And it was the best freaking thing I've ever had. And I told everybody about it on Facebook, and they're like, where have you been?
Grey Goose is waiting for Crayhen.
Grey Goose.
Yes.
Dude, if you like Grey Goose, go to Costco and get Kirkland's brand vodka, because it is actually Grey Goose in a plastic bottle that's half the price.
Shut the front door.
It is Grey Goose vodka. It is manufactured by Grey Goose, put in a plastic bottle, and they slap a Kirkland's sticker on it.
Good looking out.
Can't buy it in Pennsylvania, though. Not allowed to,
nope,
not allowed
you can't
to
buy it at Costco.
Nope. Costco is the nation's leading retailer, except in Pennsylvania. And you can't buy
alcohol in Massachusetts either.
Oh, really? Oh. Nope. Well, we're old states. That's why. We've got old laws.
We have blue laws.
There are certain towns in Pennsylvania where you're not allowed to wear pants with pockets in them. Just think about it for a second. It's an old.
So therefore, that computer could not have had the AOL disk in its drawers.
Right. Think about it for a second. Just take a guess. Sure. Why you think that is, and then we're gonna wrap it up. Why would you not be allowed to wear pants with pockets?
Guns, hidden things, drugs. No, I don't know.
Hip flask. During Prohibition, they outlawed pants with pockets so you couldn't have a hip flask full of alcohol. There's still towns that you are not allowed to wear pants in.
No pants. No pants allowed. I like those towns. Where are those towns? Because I am heading there right now.
No pants allowed.
No pants. The pantsless town.
Newport Richey? Doesn't Newport Richey have new pants? Beaches?
There are new beaches in a lot of places. I don't know. All right. But yes, one in not Florida, a lot of our Miami.
Okay.
You can follow the show on Twitter at Hotscast. I am at Rillandune. That is RILANDUNE. Kaylee is at NerdyChar, NERDICHAR. And Mike is at Fimless, FIMLYS. Head to the show's homepage at Hotscast.com for links to our Facebook, Google Plus, YouTube pages, show notes, videos, and more. You can email the show at hotscast@gmail.com. For all the services you could possibly think of that relate to a podcast, we can be found as Hotscast. And if you find one that you can't find us as Hotscast, let us know and we will rectify the situation. Mike can be found over at the Twisted Nether, twistednether.net, with his faithful cohort Hydra, talking about all the WoW things. You can hear Nerdy Char over there talking about geeky love and how to find it on the internet with our good friend Adam. Over on Charred Hearts, which is by far the greatest name of any show ever made, charredhearts.com.
Adam, also known as Ace.
What's that?
Adam, also known as Ace.
Adam, also known as Ace at 584.
Is that his initials? That might be his initials.
0584?
Oh, no, yeah, Ace. Because Ace is his initials. But yeah, last name.
I bet it's his initials. Oh, I bet that's his initials. Bet that's his middle name is his C.
Maybe he was born in 1984. I didn't think he was that young, much younger than me.
84? Yeah, he is young. He is very young.
Because he's like just a year or maybe 2 years older than me.
He's a youngin'.
Young people.
He just got the ability to drink like 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
That's not accurate. You
can find this show, Twist Into the Podcast, Charred Hearts on iTunes, Stitchers, and any other podcatcher of your choosing. Help out the show. Leave us a review on Stitcher or iTunes, and we'll read your name out on the show. And if you do leave us a review, please let us know. Ping us on Twitter, send us an email, because, like I said, none of us use iTunes, so sometimes it's hard for us to find it.
Otherwise, we'll read it 4 months
later. Not regularly.
Otherwise, we'll read it 4 months late. Until next time, folks. Not normally. Never stop asking yourself that question. Who is your hero? Cheers.
Good night. Happy New Year. Woo.
Happy New Year.
Yay.